Teach this to you. We've got Christmas time coming up, so there's plenty of good time to share some teamwork. So now we're ready to get some inspiration here. So our countdown. Almost. There we go. Here we go.
Dowels moved much like a shark. Fast, sleek, hungry. The 17-year-old played football, track, and basketball at Riverview High School.
He's also a 4.0 student, you know, just awesome, awesome kid.
On a fast track to a college scholarship, a late-night drive home after a meet brought his dreams to a screeching halt.
I was really tired. I fell asleep. But when I fell asleep, I drive that route so much that I dreamt that I was going to my house. I woke up under the semi-truck, and that's all I remember.
At Tampa General Hospital, doctors diagnosed Antonio with a spinal cord injury.
My mind went berserk. I went crazy. I'm like, okay. And I just broke down. I couldn't pray.
Now, hands that stole this football from the intended receiver could no longer move. And legs that carried him to second place in state track finals, motionless. From that moment on, Antonio's goals changed.
A long way back to do rehabilitation, but here today is Antonio to share that with perseverance and hard work, nothing is impossible. How about a hand again for Antonio Dowels?
Cool seeing that video again. It's been like 10 years. Hello, everyone. It's an honor and privilege to come and say a few words to the kids that's graduating. Who would have thought like over 20 years ago, my mom was a daycare teacher right across the street, right over where the little crab shack was, and I went to the daycare there for a few years, that I'll be right over here again speaking to kids. You know, I never thought in my life I would, you know, actually be in a speaker anywhere. You know, I just wanted to get out of the inner city and, you know, try to get my mom out of there. So I'm just happy that, you know, God has, you know, did wonderful things. So like the video said, I'm born and raised here in Tampa, moved a lot, had a single mom with four kids. I always knew that I wanted to be something great. I was a really, really, really bad kid, but I was really smart. I always knew that, you know, education would take me to places I wanted to go. So I always looked on TV, saw like Dubai and Tokyo, and always said, I'm gonna get there one day. So I always stayed focused. But again, I was really bad, got in trouble a lot for doing the bad things. And but you know, one day I was just like, you know what, I'm gonna start, you know, being focused, also be a good person as well as a good student. So I started working, stayed out of trouble. You know, my friends would hang out and go do bad things. I never really got around those crowds, but got to high school. I was pretty good at sports, so I played like three sports. And you know, I was going places. I worked right after whatever sport I was playing. Had to, you know, work till like 11 o'clock, drive all the way to Temple Terrace where I lived at the time when I was in high school, and had to do my homework until like 2 o'clock in the morning, drive all the way back to Riverview every day. And then that took its toll on me when I was a junior in high school, like the video showed. I was driving home from a track meet, just made a mistake, super excited, 1 o'clock in the morning, and I was right on 301 driving, and I fell asleep when I was driving. And they said that I was going 70 miles an hour, and I ran the red light, and I hit a semi truck, so I broke my neck. So then I had to be airlifted to the Tampa General, was there like 6 months. Like the video said, I broke my neck, so woke up, couldn't move, nothing, chest down, couldn't move my fingers. So, you know, my grandma came in and said, you know, what are you gonna do with your life? Either you're gonna make something of it, or you're just gonna sit and stay in the house all day. So, you know, I always said that I wanted to be something special, that I wanted to, you know, do something great in life. So I listened to my grandma, and you know, I went back to school, ended up going, graduated high school. Then I went to the University of Florida, go Gators. And then, you know, after that, I was actually going to school to be a doctor. So I'm going to go to medical school, and then to change my mind the last semester. So I ended up going to law school, where I became a lawyer. So, you know, I right now I have my own firm. I'm the cool lawyer, not the one that you see in the court that's very boring and lie a lot. I'm the business lawyer, so I start and run people's businesses. And like I dreamed when I was young, I got to do what I wanted to do, which is travel. So I actually just came back a couple weeks ago from Europe. So I went to Germany, Switzerland, Italy, and England. Had a great time. So every year I go to at least 2 countries, and it's because I work hard. Why I tell my story? Because, you know, years ago, many, many years ago, I was just in your seat, you know, wondering about my future, what I was going to do. I knew I wanted to be great, but I really didn't know, you know. Single mom, like I said, she worked 2 jobs, barely saw her that much. Just keep food on my table. So, you know, I always tell people when I give speeches, what you should do is always believe in yourself. Because there's always people that tell you what you can't do, especially growing up where we grew up. You know, a lot of people would say this bad kid, you know, tell my mom I need to be on medication. He won't do much. But, you know, look at me now. It's not because I believed in all the negative stuff. I believed in what God put in my heart. You know, to be something special. The next thing I would say, write down your goals. A lot of people always think about what they want to do, but if you don't write them down, you know, a lot of people just forget about it. The next thing is, you know, creating a healthy relationship with people. You have amazing parents, you know, they have to be amazing when they're coming out after work, who love and support you. When you're in school, don't hang around those bad people, because you become the people that you hang out with. I always stayed away. I had cool friends in school, but after school, I couldn't hang out with them because all they did was go and get in trouble, go to jail, and that kind of stuff. And then, you know, lastly, I would say you know, follow your dreams. What I tell people is, like, if you can breathe and if you can think, anything is possible, you know? Look at me. I can move 80% of my body, but I got my own law firm. I live in my own house, I drive and everything. So if I can do it, you
especially can do it. There's a lot of people out here who believe in you. Stick with those people. You guys can do whatever you put your mind to. And I look forward to seeing you guys flourish in the future. Thank you.
All right. Character GPS. We also have another board member, Leslie Lubick. Leslie, wave your hand here. And so they believe in you guys. You are the future, right? And so we have to invest in you, or there's no future, right? We've got to help you get onto a path for success. So you know Miss Debbie and our board, they're all pulling for you. And you're going to have an opportunity once you realize now that you've got the tools for success. Now it's what are you going to do with them, right? And so we were passing around, and Ms. Lubick has the sign up. If you want to help us with summer camps, we help kids just like you in a whole week. In 1 week, they learn the whole program. It's a deep dive. But if you would like to be a mentor in coaching, encouraging kids to get on track and make good decisions, we can, again, give you service hours. We can write recommendations for you. But it's a powerful experience. And one of our former mentors, Edward, is from Berkeley. And Edward, you want us to say something real quick? You're heading on to college and being a mentor. What did it mean to you, being a mentor, to help another kid, kind of coaching him along?
Being a mentor for me was just an incredible experience to kind of see, you know, at a fast, quick time frame, the ways that you can already start giving back and using your good character to help others. And so that's something I think is, you know, really amazing.